Man, they actually did it. Jags fans, they were saying that they were going to come to the final game of the season wearing these clown costumes to kind of protest and mock the owner, Shad Khan, and the GM. I didn't really think that they were going to do it. But, man, rather than winning many games this season, the Jags just keep finding new ways to embarrass themselves all year, and they just continue to be the laughing stock of the NFL. Now, I know a lot of people probably thinking, like, oh man, this probably just started with this whole Urban Meyer stint. But no. This is years of built-up frustration from Giants fans. And I guess they just had to let it out, man. Man, buku fans in Jacksonville came to the game. Not only, they didn't even come with the bags over their face like how they used to do in New Orleans or like how they did in Detroit at one point. But no, they were actually wearing clown costumes, man. And some people went the whole nine and had the whole shebang with the makeup, the outfit, and everything. Others, man, you have people out there with just the red noses and the clown wigs, but regardless, they actually went through with it to try to send a message to the front office. And to be honest, though, it's not like nobody in the front office will even care slightly. Shad Khan has always been known as like a hands-off, laid-back kind of owner, and rather than fixing a sinking ship, he'll damn near just count down and see how long it takes for it to reach to the bottom. So, I don't think anybody in the front office cares about this, to be completely honest. Now, I'm not a Giants fan, because I do love myself, and I would never put myself in a situation like that. But I am from Jacksonville. I grew up there, so I always kind of had like a soft spot for the hometown team. And man, times have always been hard for Jacksonville, man. I remember those blackout games to where you couldn't even, not only could you not watch the Jazz games, even if they were at home playing the game, you couldn't even watch any damn game in the NFL until after the Jags finished that game that nobody could even watch if they wanted to, man. And growing up, my first job as a kid was I used to sell parking spots at Jaguars games with my pops, and we'll often get free Jaguar tickets. And when I tell you, excuse me, when I tell you that people could not give away those tickets for free, let alone even sell it, man, unless like they were playing like, unless the Jags were playing like the Steelers or the Patriots or the Cowboys, where they would have like big fan bases in the city or in damn near every city in America, and they just wanted to come to the game to see their teams beat down on the Jags, man. But man, most people in Jacksonville are not even Giants fans, and that's just calling it is what it is, man. I became a Titans fan because as a kid, man, my first Jags games that I went to, I didn't know nothing about football. I just told myself, whoever wins that game, I'll start rooting for them. And surprise, surprise, the Giants got they ass beat. And now here I am, a Titans fan from Jacksonville who never even stepped foot in the state of Tennessee. And man, to be honest, you didn't even really see too many Jags fans in public until after like that 2017 season to where they went to the AFC Championship game and lost. I'm not saying that they weren't out there, but they just weren't like out there like how they are now, you know. But I really don't blame them because the only thing that the Jags can do right is get top five picks every year in the draft. And don't even get me started with how the Jags kept flirting with the idea of relocating to another city for years. So I really think it was appropriate for these Jags fans to wear these clown outfits and stuff like that because, man, the Jaguars organization has been like a circus that's been ran by nothing but clowns for years, and this is 100%, no, 1,000% appropriate. Yes, they did win, and I will give them that, and they did cancel the Colts' playoff hopes. And if there's one thing about sports fans is that they love to be spiteful towards their rival and to extend misery to them. So on top of them sabotaging the Colts season two, they still managed to hold on to that number one draft pick. So that's a win on top of the win. So that is a little plus. But man, enough of me going on the Jags. I really hope that they can consistently start doing better because yes, it's fun to clown them. No pun intended, but yes, it is fun to clown them. But man, all of this is for the birds, man. And the city really does deserve better from the Jaguars, man. And I don't know, it's just embarrassing and it's just getting out of hand, man. But let me know what you guys think in the comments. Don't forget to like this video, don't forget to share it, don't forget to subscribe. And I really appreciate the support, man.